So what is going on YouTube? Thank you so much for tuning into Skated Informant. I miss you guys, hope you guys miss me as well. Today is July 25th, about, 4 o'clock p.m. Here in the U.S. Central Time. I need to say that because since we are dealing with the Olympics, I don't know where you're tuning in from, where you're clicking from, but you're here now, which is what's important. So day one concluded. Today's Sunday. Yesterday was Saturday in the U.S. Again, it's already, later in the day in Japan. However, for us, we're on the western side of the world here. Things kind of just settled for us. The results of the Olympics were pretty dope. Japan took it, number one. Brazil with Vincent, number two. And, Jagger with that bronze. I think that's super dope because, if you're the hosting country and you end up with a gold medal on this new sport, then, wow, let's promote this even more. Our country is very talented. So I can just imagine all the investments, all the hype that this will create, even further in Japan. So I'm just excited for them in general. I'm excited for all skateboarding. Brazil, is that really a surprise? Is it really surprising that Brazil landed with the medal? It's not. It was going to be one way or another. So Vincent took it. Just from an observational perspective, it always baffles me in a good way that, sometimes I make the mistake of thinking that good skateboarders are usually very thin or even skinny, an appearance and weight, body mass, etc. But Vincent is not a skinny dude. Vincent, I don't think his nickname is, Slim. No hate towards the guy, man. He's 10 times more talented than I'll ever be. However, man, silver in the Olympics, dude, it's more so about skill than it is about weight on, body fat, etc. Skill. Use your tools to your advantage. So jumping up and down, 12 stairs over and over, bailing and stuff. So just amazing. So Brazil took that one, hard earned, definitely. And Jagger, man, the young, fresh kid, the pretty boy, just killing it. If you were tuning into the Olympics, you saw how he has this routine where he goes up to the quarter really fast, really aggressive, and does blunt and then kickflip. But it's so aggressive, it's so hard, it's so fast that it's kind of risky. In my opinion, if you're in the middle of a run of a transition, if you do a trick, go up to the quarter, then you're just gonna come back down to do another trick. Don't risk it on the middle of your run. But that's the type of things that judges like to see. You take chances, bigger outcomes, etc. So he landed himself a nice medal. If I were ever in the Olympics, I would be colorblind as far as what color that medal has. I have a medal in the freaking Olympics. World, I'm number three in the world. Dude, that's just a privilege. First Olympics, in skateboarding ever. Super dope. Now, further, even beyond just saying who was, first, second, third, there's some things I definitely want to capitalize and talk about in regards to this subject. Because before the Olympics, I was like a lot of other people online that are very, against this being an Olympic sport. Because, it's not a sport. It's hard to measure, you measure a ball sport. But let's look at the overall results of the finalists. So if you were not tuning into the Olympics, the way it works, I'm sure a lot of other contests are the same. It's a big pool of people that have qualified prior to the Olympics, right? And you have this group of people that have qualified. Now, once you're there, that group of people, the qualifiers, now have to re-qualify to make it to the finals in the Olympics. So in this scenario, somebody that I like to mention that did not make it at all, you can see here, it goes down to eighth place because these were the finalists. And you don't see people like Felipe Gustavo. To me, that is a shocker. Felipe Gustavo is not on here, right? Amongst these ads. he's not on here. So what happened to Felipe Gustavo? Is he not good? He's a destroyer. But here is why now the reason why Felipe did not make it to the finals in the Olympics to me is the reason why now I kind of like to see more skateboarding in the Olympics. Here's why. Because like before the Olympics started, some relatives and close friends reached out to me, you know, DM me, said, hey, so you know, you've been skateboarding all your life, Raul, so who do you think is gonna take it? And all three of the people that I suggested did not even get a medal. I said, well, you're gonna see Naija get a medal. I'd say Ribeiro is gonna get a medal. And then I said, who else did I say? Let me see. It was like, Ariel, I always mess up his name, Aurelien. I said Aurelien, I said Naija, and Gustavo Ribeiro. I said, watch, that's gonna happen. Dude, none of them got any medals. Like those three people that I nominated in my little circle, people that came to me as you're the skateboarding master, and none of them got it. Now, are they some of the heavy hitters? I mean, if you follow Aurelien, he's doing tray flips that almost reach the ceiling of his skate warehouse. So do these people, actually, they're right here next to one another in that order. That's so embarrassing. I basically told people, yeah, these three are gonna take it, and they're actually the exact opposite happened. They're in the very bottom. So the Olympics ended up being more like a chess game. We talked about Felipe Gustavo. Felipe Gustavo did not even qualify to the finals. Why? Well, if you weren't tuning in, you needed to have at least 4 scores to even be considered to qualify for the finals. At least 4 scores. That means that if you had like 7 tries or 8 tries, or 8 tries, and you bail, when you bail, that's a 0, and that doesn't even count as even like a nothing, not even like a 1. So Felipe was going for, what was it? It was like a switch, kickflip, crook, or a variation of that. I don't remember what it was, but he was stuck on this one trick that he just wanted to get. And I respect him, because it's go all out or go home. You're not gonna come here just to do, you know, little things, just to qualify, just to get by. That's not the Brazilian way, I'm pretty sure. But he was trying that up until he ran out of attempts, and he didn't even get 4 scores. He bailed everything else. He just got 3, and he bailed everything else. So he didn't even qualify for the judges to look at his scores and say, okay, you move on or you stay. Not even. So he basically disqualified himself by bailing too many tries. That to me, if I was in his position and my first 3 scores were kind of good, I would like, bro, flip it. I'll just do a 50-50 just to get 4 scores and then see if I move on. Having a chance to move forward or not moving up, you know, at all is a huge difference. That's just me. And then you see Gustavo Ribeiro, he did that. He knew he wasn't going to qualify, but he at least wanted to have a bigger score than having a lesser score. Mind you, he knew he wasn't going to qualify or to win anything. So he did a just 50-50 on a handrail, and that was it. And he understood that. People like, I see what he's doing. He's letting it go, but he's doing something. Because at the end of the day, guess what? It's a numbers game. When you set somebody for a first, second, third, fourth, whatever, all the way down to, you know, 15, it's a numbers game. Eventually, even if you don't get a medal, they'll say, okay, you're 4th place. Oh, look, you're 5th place, and so forth. So he knew that he wanted to get some good or something at least higher than the next guy. And as you can see here, Yuto with the gold, Kelvin and Jagger, their scores are not very different, very far apart. Like for example, Yuto and Kelvin, dude, that's like a point difference. That's literally a point difference right there. If he would have messed something up, these could easily flip completely. Just like, bam, now Yuto silver and Kelvin's gold. That's how much of a point system it is. Now, I get it. People hate this, but it's a new discipline. You know, one can say, I'm a swimmer. I'm an Olympic swimmer. Okay. but how long can you hold your breath underwater? Man, forget, that's not all that's important. I can swim really fast. Okay, cool, but are you scared of seeing how long can you hold your breath underwater? Okay, let's do it. Bam, he completely loses. Like, what's going on? Dude, it's just a different discipline. The guy that beats you may not swim as fast as you can, but he has a super developed skill that is holding his breath underwater for super long. So this and skateboarding, the Olympics, kind of like the same thing in my mind. Like, yes, skateboarding shouldn't be rated at these very specific point systems, very granular, you know, replays. Did he touch the floor? Did he toe drag? He gets a 0.1, 0.2. Like, no, skateboarding is not about that. I get that. But it's a new discipline. Some of these guys can get these tricks in one try. Therefore, you can qualify to the Olympics. While you have people that are incredibly talented, but they don't get things in their first try. Maybe it takes them 10 tries, 15 tries. Therefore, you don't have enough skill or position to make it to an Olympic event. Not that you're better than them or that they're better than you, but it's a different type of discipline in that you can show the world that you have mastered this discipline. That's where I get excited. That's where it's new. That's where it's fresh. That's where skateboarding hadn't seen this before. There's Jagger, bam. That was ridiculous. And it was so clean too. And you can just tell that this is new to the world because you start seeing headliners like this. Okay, these are the scores, but do you wanna know what the Olympic bronze medalist Jagger was listening to? Wow, a talk show. What were you listening to, Jagger? Like, yeah, skateboarding has definitely, and if it wasn't there before, skateboarding has entered mainstream media, mainstream sports. So these are the type of things that you're gonna have to deal with, you know, on the in the crosshairs and the crossfire here, but it's okay. Something else that I was very excited to see is that people like Gustavo is owning up to, you know, like maybe things not happening the way he wanted it to, but he's saying that he still has a lot of respect towards everyone else, that he enjoyed this experience because, dude, it's the first Olympic. You've been immortalized now. This too, he has a busted shoulder and he kept landing on that shoulder too. So everyone's so excited, and it's a once in a lifetime opportunity, I think. Well, maybe they'll still qualify. Some of these people are going to be there in the next Olympics, but these are things that are really great opportunities. So even though I had a busted, you know, knee or knee's a little different because we got to pop, but you know, wrist. There was another guy from South Africa that had a broken wrist in two places, and also like Gustavo Ribeiro, like he had a busted shoulder. He's still doing his thing, so I definitely respect that. Here are the winners. And the funny thing about this is that they're all friends. They're all always skating like the barracks or skate parks, you know, just like we're skateboarders. We intertwine, we talk with a bunch of people all the time. So this is Felipe Gustavo's post. And one thing for sure that nobody can take away from Felipe is that he was the first person to skate in the Olympics for skateboarding. He was. Nollie flip, no slide, first trick in the Olympic history. So I know Gustavo didn't really make it the way he wanted to, so I feel like he is definitely like holding on to the positive of his run, and he's just excited for that. But yeah, remember, he did not qualify to be a finalist. Yeah, everyone's reporting that he's the first one to skate in the Olympics, so they give him that much, you know, and it's so true. But hey, Brazil did take it, so his country still made it and made it good. That is silver, my guy. So definitely no hate, love for everyone. But yeah, and one more thing that was like really mind-blowing. You guys, I'm sure, know about SLS, right? SLS, made by Rob Dyrdek. And you know, it's street league. It's where people skateboard and you get point system, and suspiciously very similar to the Olympics. Even the layout of the Olympics, like the, I guess the park itself is extremely similar to SLS. Rob Dyrdek is an entrepreneur, man. I would not be surprised if whenever the Olympic organization, you know, said, okay, we want to incorporate skateboarding in the Olympics, what does it take? Who has a system, a point system? Since everyone is over there dissing on the Olympics being including skateboarding, nobody had something to offer except SLS. I would not be surprised if SLS sold them the blueprint of the rating systems, the scores. I'm sure the Olympics made tweaks to them, but that layout looks so similar to SLS. So Rob Dyrdek, I don't know if it's disclosed or not, but I'm pretty sure the Olympics came to you and got some kind of advisory consultant work from you, because you sold that, man. And that looks just like SLS. And now it's in the Olympics. So it's a game chess, man. Both on the park, off the park, it's a chess game everywhere. These business guys are just killing it. I'm so proud of everyone that was involved in making this this happen. Also, something I should mention, that some of the judges, all judges are former skateboarders. So like Garrett Hill is one of them. One of the judges was Garrett Hill. Can you imagine? You were hired to be a judge at the Olympics. At the Olympics, you were a judge. The Olympic organization hired you because of your resume. So that is so dope. And I can just imagine the amount of jobs that are gonna come out from these events. So many jobs will come out of these events. Before, like, you would see articles where it says what to do once you are no longer a professional skateboarder. What jobs can you obtain? Well, you can obtain this or that, like random jobs, like work at a warehouse. I'm sure they pay you okay money. No, dude, you can be like a judge in the Olympics. Well, I'm super happy for Yuto, and I can just think the women's session is going to be amazing, and the men's vert session is going to be amazing too, and the remainder of these events. So thank you so much for watching. This is it for now. We can talk about the results of today's sessions tomorrow. Until then, I am the skin informant. You've been informed. My job here is done, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.